Coming up next, a middleweight tilt between Ronaldo Souza and Kelvin Gastelum. Well, Kelvin Gastelum has been a dominant force nearly every step of the way thus far in the UFC. All the skills you would like to see in a future UFC champion: striking, takedowns, takedown defense, 10th planet jiu-jitsu, very opportunistic with his submission game. And of course, he's got the ticker to boot, Joe. This is a tough force to be reckoned with at 185 or 170 pounds.
Kelvin Gastelum combines heart, will, determination, cardio, and outstanding wrestling. And all of those made for a successful combination when he won the UFC's Ultimate Fighter.
So here's the former Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu world champion, Ronaldo Chacaré Souza. You know, we trot out the term world class when it comes to Jiu-Jitsu a lot in MMA, and maybe more than we should. Chacaré Souza is world class personified, still chasing down that UFC middleweight title. Perhaps tonight will be his night.
This guy is taking shots to the jaw that would put many fighters unconscious and pressed forward as if nothing happened. His chin is legendary.
For this much-anticipated middleweight encounter. Souza is 12 years his senior. He will have a one-inch reach advantage. All right, now for the particulars inside the octagon, here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC middleweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, a wrestler with a professional record of 15 wins, 3 losses, and 1 no contest. He stands 5 feet 9 inches tall, weighing in at 185 pounds. Fighting out of Yuma, Arizona, USA, Kelvin Gastelum. And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, a jiu-jitsu fighter holding professional record of 25 wins, 5 losses, and 1 no contest. He stands 6 feet 1 inch tall, weighing in at 185 pounds. Fighting out of Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, Ronaldo Chacaré Souza! And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Dan Mergliotta.
Dan Mergliotta. Here we go. If you were building a modern-day MMA athlete from scratch, you might start with Chacaré Souza. What a combination of strength, speed, power. A lot of people believe he's the best pure grappler in the UFC, but the striking has really started to close the gap. Scary proposition for every other 85er on the roster.
Oh, and he ate a front kick.
Joe, how does he approach this particular challenge tonight?
One thing to keep an eye out for in this fight are the takedowns of Kelvin Gastelum. He will often mix them in with his striking to stay unpredictable. Look at this. He's got his arm pinned down. It looks like he's got that Kimura locked up tight.
He might get a finish here.
His Kimura is getting tighter. He may be forced to tap here.
There's the tap.
Great job in getting this fight to the ground quickly and getting an early submission.
Yeah, so how about that, Joe? We can barely tell people what color the trunks are on these fighters, and we get the submission win. So not a lot of wasted time. He got the takedown early, and the submission came soon thereafter. Great effort, great technique here tonight.
And here we can see it again. Beautiful technique here on this Kimura, perfectly applied for the tap. And here we see it again. Beautiful submission victory.
So there he is, your winner by submission tonight, and that is how you put the rest of the division on notice. A huge result for him here tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Bergliotta calls a stop to this contest at 47 seconds of the very first round, declaring the winner by tap out, Ronaldo Jacare Souza.
So congratulations are certainly in order to that man, Ronaldo Jacare Souza, 5-time Jiu-Jitsu world champion, but really needed to lean on all of his MMA skills here tonight. The striking was on point, his grappling was sharp as it's ever been, and perhaps this win is enough to earn Jacare Souza a crack at that UFC middleweight title.